Alyssa Milano is back again telling you and me, the American people, what we should and should not do. I guess she didn't learn from her last interview that maybe she should shut her mouth for a while. No one wants to hear what she has to say. So after the whole Joe Biden thing came out, her interview that she did on Sirius XM, if you don't know, a few years ago or last year, I can't really remember, when the Kavanaugh hearings were coming out, Brett Kavanaugh was accused of sexual misconduct, I believe maybe even attempted rape. And the woman who accused him had a story that was not corroborated by any witnesses, couldn't say the date, couldn't say exactly when. Her story was very choppy, and Alyssa Milano was the head of the just Kavanaugh witch trial crusade, if you will, saying that you should believe all women. She went to the Kavanaugh hearing, gave him the stank face the whole time, and then when it was over, she cried about the verdict and was just heading the whole thing. And then all of a sudden, someone she's endorsing, Joe Biden, has allegations come out against him, and what does she do? She stays silent. And finally, she does a radio interview on Sirius XM, and they asked her why she stayed so silent. And she said, I've known Joe a long time. You know, we don't have all the evidence out. Every man should have due process, and we should never ruin a man's reputation until we have all the information. Right? So where was this level-headed thinking when the whole Kavanaugh thing was going on? And let me also point out that no, he hasn't been convicted of anything. And yes, she's right. Everyone deserves due process. Yes, most women would not make up a story, but the allegation against Biden is way more detailed. She has the exact date, knows everything. It seems very odd. And I feel sorry for Alyssa Milano. At the same time, I'm scared of her, because you almost have to be a sociopath to not see the hypocrisy in this whole thing. So that happened. And you would think that maybe she would say, wow, this isn't a good look for me. I'm going to stay low for a little while. Oh no, she didn't. She released a video that she did on her own to her large following, urging people that they shouldn't be going out and buying guns during the pandemic, because those guns that they buy could be turned around and used in a shooting or on the street or in a household to injure other people. When in actuality, the reason there is a gun surge is so that people are able to protect themselves, and that is protected under the Second Amendment. Might I also add this? About maybe it was a year ago, maybe a little less than a year, maybe over a year ago, Alyssa Milano actually sat down with Senator Ted Cruz, and they had a discussion in which she admitted that she has two guns in her household for self-protection. And she's trying to urge you, the American people, to not go out and buy guns. I don't know if she's trying to stay relevant, if she's trying to do good in the world by sitting up and virtue signaling, but this is not how you do it, Alyssa. You are a huge hypocrite. And quite frankly, it is terrifying that a person can be so far up their own behinds that they're not unaware of the hypocrisy and of the actual message that they're sending out to people. So that's my thoughts on what happened with Alyssa Milano. I'm actually now starting to think that there might be something mentally off with her. I don't know, but it's really disgusting. And you know, while I am disgusted, at the same time, it is lovely how this person is actually exposing their hypocrisy to this point, because people that didn't see it before are starting to see it now. This is something I've known for a long time, and I'm sure a lot of you have known, but now the general public is starting to see, wow, you're a hypocrite and you're a virtue signaler, and you don't actually care about people. You care about yourself, and that's it. Okay. Whew. That's all I have to say about that. Goodbye. See you later.